every like career day has gotten me to kind of just look at other occupations.
This is definitely beneficial.
It's still cool. What you guys do is important.
Hello and welcome. Earlier this fall, the USGS Oregon Water Science Center hosted a Science Career Day for students at Rosemary Anderson High School here in Portland, Oregon. Now, the goal of the day was relatively simple. Introduce the students to life as a scientist. And if all went well, hopefully demonstrate how epically awesome this career choice is. Granted, this is no small feat, and we won't know for a while how successful we were. Regardless, we gave it a try, and this video shows you how.
The fact that we're still in high school and we're trying to prep for college, like this is really like, this is like an ideal thing to take part in.
We should take this field trip as a learning experience and listen and take in all the information we can.
Now that I'm more informed, I'm kind of leaning towards the science because it's something that I actually really like.
So what motivated our career day? Well, the USGS is an aging workforce. And like any other organization, we can definitely benefit from an influx of talented, motivated, and diverse young scientists and professionals. Now, if you want to replicate this Science Career Day, here's what you're going to need to know for planning your event.
You know, when I used to think of science, I used to think of just biology, physics, and chemistry, like not these different branches and all that.
I didn't even know you guys did anything like this.
Today is going to be designed to give you a sense of what possible kinds of careers and jobs there are related to science. If science sounds interesting to you, keep us on your radar screen because something could open up.
We're trying to reach out to young adults, high schoolers, I mean even sometimes as low as middle school, just introduce them to science.
I wanted to start out just hearing a little bit about what you guys want to do when you're done with high school, where you see yourself going next.
After high school, I am planning on going straight into college. I'm kind of just going to find my way.
I want to just start college immediately because what I want to do, I'm going to have to do 7 years of college, so I don't want to waste any time.
I'm trying to go PCC and then take my transfer grade to OSU and go to OSU for biology.
Okay, so I'll tell you guys a little bit about how I got to be where I am today. So I grew up in the Midwest. And just spending a lot of time, you know, out by creeks and rivers and seeing plants and animals outside, I thought maybe science would be something that I could get into. I was lucky enough to find a career counselor who sent me to a program at Gateway Community College. And right off the bat, they got me an internship with the U.S. Geological Survey.
I do a lot of different things, you know. Like I said, one day I'm driving a boat, one day I'm building the chamber, maybe on the computer for a day or two. I'm out in the field. I take my job very seriously because I know other people rely on some of the things that I do, so I know that I want to do it as best as I can. We're non-biased. We aren't in the profit-making business. You know, we aren't out here to make a bunch of money. We're out here to serve the public. I want to ask you guys, what is your ideal work environment?
I want a job that I can enjoy, that, yeah, pays good and all that. Something that I can make a living out of that I love.
I'm just looking for something I would enjoy. Like, I don't want a job where I just sit behind an office all day.
I like flexibility. All of the jobs that we talked about this morning are all flexible.
After lunch, students geared up for some field work. This mostly included working with stream flow and water quality instrumentation.
They look pretty involved and really interested.
Science isn't boring. Science is more than just sitting at a desk crunching numbers.
This reading would be pretty worthless because we're not getting a true measurement of what the water clarity is.
Okay.
So we either have to move upstream or wait till all this settled out.
Okay. So we just made a measurement.
I mean, it can handle getting wet, but it can't be submerged for an extended period of time.
Okay. You guys want to gather around? We can take a look at our measurement we just made?
Water quality mark.
You guys want to gather around, take a look at this? Could even have you guys, somebody load it up.
I'm going to try to get it over the tide just to get them to write some of these numbers down for me.
Cool. Well, thank you guys very, very much. I appreciate you guys being able to come out and spend the day with us and give us some feedback.
Well, that's the gist of our USGS Science Career Day. It was a fun and rewarding day, and it couldn't have been done without the help of Rosemary Anderson High School and the USGS Diversity Council. Now, if you want to replicate this, or if you have any questions or comments about this Science Career Day, please feel free, email us at oroutreach@usgs.gov.
Are you guys ready?
Yes. Yep.
On the count of three, one, two, three.